In 2005, astronomers made an incredible discovery, a 10th planet in our solar system, larger than Pluto. But how did they find it? And what did it mean for our understanding of the solar system? The search for the 10th planet began in the early 2000s, as astronomers were studying objects beyond Neptune known as trans-Neptunian objects, or TNOs. These icy bodies are difficult to see, as they are very small and very far away. But astronomers noticed something strange about the orbits of some of these TNOs. They seem to be influenced by the gravity of a large object farther out in the solar system. So, astronomers began searching for this mystery object. They used some of the world's most powerful telescopes to scan the skies for any signs of a large, distant planet. And in 2005, they found it. The 10th planet, later named Eris, was located about 3 times farther from the Sun than Pluto, and was about the same size as Pluto. But the discovery of Eris led to a bigger debate: what actually qualifies as a planet? Up until this point, scientists had defined a planet as a celestial body that orbits the Sun, is spherical in shape, and has cleared its orbit of other debris. But Eris didn't seem to fit that definition, as its orbit was still cluttered with other TNOs. The debate over the definition of a planet raged on for years, eventually leading to the demotion of Pluto from planet status. But regardless of its official classification, the discovery of the 10th planet was a major milestone in our understanding of the solar system. And who knows what other discoveries are waiting to be made, as astronomers continue to explore the farthest reaches of our cosmic neighborhood. The 10th planet, also known as Eris, is located in the Kuiper Belt, a region beyond Neptune that is filled with icy objects left over from the formation of the solar system. Eris is about 3 times farther from the Sun than Pluto and takes more than 500 years to orbit the Sun. Eris is a cold and distant world, with temperatures that can drop to nearly 400 degrees below zero Fahrenheit. Its surface is covered in ice, but unlike Pluto, it doesn't have a substantial atmosphere. This means that Eris doesn't have the same dramatic features as Pluto, like mountains and valleys. Eris's orbit is highly elliptical, meaning that it is much more elongated than the orbits of the other planets in our solar system. This suggests that Eris was formed in a different part of the solar system and was later scattered to its current location by the gravitational pull of the gas giants. Studying Eris and other objects in the Kuiper Belt can tell us a lot about the early history of the solar system. These icy bodies are thought to be remnants from the time when the planets were forming, and they have been preserved in their original state ever since. Scientists are continuing to study Eris and other objects in the Kuiper Belt, using telescopes and spacecraft to learn more about their properties and origins. By studying these distant worlds, we can unlock secrets about the formation of our solar system and the processes that shaped our cosmic neighborhood. Up until this point, scientists had defined a planet as a celestial body that orbits the Sun, is spherical in shape, and has cleared its orbit of other debris. But Eris didn't seem to fit that definition, as its orbit was still cluttered with other trans-Neptunian objects, or TNOs. This led to a heated debate among scientists and astronomers about what should count as a planet. Should it be based on size, or should it be based on other factors, like whether it has a moon or an atmosphere? Some argued that Eris and other similar objects should be considered planets, as they meet the basic criteria of being spherical and orbiting the Sun. Others argued that the definition of a planet should be more strict, and that only the 8 traditional planets in our solar system should be considered planets. In 2006, the International Astronomical Union, IAU, finally weighed in on the debate, voting to redefine what counts as a planet. Under the new definition, a planet is a celestial body that orbits the Sun, is spherical in shape, and has cleared its orbit of other debris. This decision meant that Pluto and Eris were no longer considered planets, but rather were classified as dwarf planets, a new category of celestial objects that don't meet the strict definition of a planet. The decision was controversial, with some arguing that it was arbitrary and that there should be a more inclusive definition of a planet. Others argued that the new definition was necessary to maintain scientific accuracy and consistency. The debate over planethood may seem trivial, but it highlights the importance of clear definitions and standards in scientific research. And who knows what other debates and discoveries are waiting to be made, as astronomers continue to explore the farthest reaches of our cosmic neighborhood. The 10th planet in our solar system, also known as Eris, is located in the Kuiper Belt and is larger than Pluto. But did you know that Eris also has a moon? The moon, named Dysnomia, was discovered in 2005, shortly after Eris was first observed. Dysnomia is much smaller than Eris, but it still provides important insights into the history and formation of the Kuiper Belt. Scientists believe that Eris and Dysnomia were formed at the same time, from the same material, in the same region of the Kuiper Belt. They likely formed as a result of a collision between two large objects, which created a debris field that eventually coalesced into Eris and Dysnomia. Dysnomia orbits Eris at a distance of about 37,000 miles, and it takes just over 15 days to complete one orbit. Dysnomia's orbit is highly elliptical, which suggests that it was captured by Eris's gravity after it formed, rather than forming in place like the moons of the gas giants. Studying Eris and Dysnomia can tell us a lot about the early history of the Kuiper Belt and the processes that shaped our solar system. By analyzing their compositions and orbits, scientists can learn about the materials and conditions that existed in the Kuiper Belt billions of years ago. In addition to Dysnomia, there are many other moons and small objects in the Kuiper Belt, each with its own unique properties and characteristics. Studying these objects is crucial to our understanding of the early solar system and the formation of our cosmic neighborhood. While Eris is not considered to be a likely candidate for life, some scientists believe that it is possible that life could exist in the subsurface oceans of other icy worlds in our solar system, such as Europa and Enceladus. These subsurface oceans could provide a habitat for microbial life, protected from the harsh radiation and extreme cold of the surface. While there are no current plans to explore Eris specifically, studying its composition and characteristics can provide valuable insights into the early history of our solar system and the conditions that could support life in other parts of the universe. The 10th planet, also known as Eris, has captivated the imaginations of scientists and science fiction fans alike. From books to movies and TV shows, Eris has made its mark in popular culture. In science fiction, Eris is often depicted as a mysterious and dangerous world, with extreme weather conditions and harsh environments. It has been featured in movies like Star Trek, the motion picture, and TV shows like Doctor Who and Stargate Atlantis. Eris has also been the subject of various books and comics, often serving as a symbol of the unknown and unexplored parts of the universe.